There's a feeling you get when you are looking at kind of the core of something, like the heart or something, and it's direct and visceral. It's very rarely a stand-in or something else. It's the thing itself. I've spent all of my adult life kind of in a photographic dialogue in one sense or another with the Central Valley of California, which is the place I'm from and where I've lived my entire life. I think we're all kind of inevitably shaped by the places we come from, the environments we grow up in, and that's just something that's part of, you know, the human experience. Friday, October 23rd, 2020, Exeter, California. North through Cutler, Orosi, Fowler, to South Fresno, teeming with shanties and tents on the sidewalk. Then west and south through dusty and dry farmland to Huron, where old men, some wearing masks, pass the evening on roadside benches. East to Alpaw, where several families hang laundry out to dry in the evening. Through Early Mart to Poplar, where a walnut orchard has been recently toppled, the giant trees pulled out, lying on their sides, the roots of one tangled with the branches of another, together reaching toward the sky. Here, in the middle of California, halfway between Hollywood and Silicon Valley, you have this completely different reality. And it was a very clear, straightforward role for photography to fill there, to describe that reality. So these mythologies of America, you know, the land of opportunity, the American dream, pick yourself up by the bootstraps, all of these stories that Americans like to tell themselves about their country, I've seen over a lifetime of how all those things are not true. But those myths are so widespread that even the victims of those myths still have a hard time rejecting them. That poverty in America is seen as a personal failing rather than as a systemic problem. And that core contradiction, I guess, or sleight of hand, really, if you think of it in that way, is something that just has animated my work, my thinking about what America is, the brutality, kind of really, of the American system. There came a time in my work where I started to wonder, okay, how many other places in America are there like the Central Valley? How many other places are, you know, part of the geography of America, but not part of this American dream? Thank you. Sunday, July 3rd, 2016, Gary, Indiana. Gary is a ghost town. Broadway still runs past City Hall to the main gate of U.S. Steel, but the grandeur of that entrance has been lost. PLS check cashers and payday loans is the only open business along the road, and gray painted plywood covers the broken windows lining the sidewalk. "Don't give up" is spray painted across one of them. Near the closed gates of the steel mill, sandwiched between two highway overpasses, an abandoned train station stands crooked on its foundation like a man in broken shoes. The question I was seeking to answer was a personal question, which was how to make sense really of what I had seen and experienced in the Central Valley over all these years. Was this truly an anomaly? Was this something on the side? Or is that aspect of American life something more central? How many other places like this are there in the country? What are the connecting themes and issues in between them? And what I had found is, in fact, there are a multitude of Central Valleys across the United States, and it started a process of my very questioning the idea of what does America mean? What do these concepts of the land of opportunity and the American dream, are they even relevant today? Or is this all, some kind of fraud basically perpetrated to keep people in line? Tuesday, August 13th, 2019, Tuba City, Arizona. I talk with Jeremiah, Jacob's brother, who sells his blood to make ends meet. I hitchhike down there and get cash back. It's a source of income, And sometimes I use that to pay for our water, for our propane, stuff we need around the house, paper towels, necessities. But you're weak sometimes. Photography, in the end, I think necessarily does end up being this deeply human affirmation of life. Even the difficult parts, it's a way of trying to reckon with those difficult parts and a way of trying to make sense of the world. That's profoundly human.